Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to my Maths Online class. So today we will discuss the exercise 2.5. Okay? So all of you, open your books, page number 21. First, see question number 1. Compare the numbers using greater than, less than, or equal. So we have to put this symbol between the numbers. Okay? At first, see example A. The two numbers are given. We have to put these symbols, one of these symbols. So what will we put between these and how can we compare this? See, remember the first rule. First we have to count the digits, that how many digits are there in the numbers, both the numbers. So first count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, this is 5-digit number and this, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, both are 5-digit numbers. So, now, what we have to do? We have to compare the digits from leftmost end. So, see, 3. Here, in the leftmost, 3 is present. So, this is same. After that, here 5. Also 5. 3. Here what? 4. So this is different. And here 3 is present. Here 4 is present. So we know that 3 is less than 4. So what symbol we use between this? This. Understand? So this number is less than this number. 35,306 is less than 35,409. Understand? Now see example B. First of all, we are going to count the digits. That how many digits are there in the both numbers. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? This is 6-digit number. And this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is also 6-digit number. Now, we have to compare digits from the leftmost end. So see, 4. Here also 4 present. 8, 8, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, this 0, here also 0. So this number is equal to this number. So what we have to put this? Put here equal sign. Understand? So I have done A and B for you. You have to do C, D, E, F. Okay? Now see question number 2. Insert commas and arrange the following numbers in ascending order. So first we have to insert commas. Okay. After that we have to arrange these given numbers in ascending order. Do you remember what is ascending order? Means from smaller to bigger. Okay. So I will take this for example. Okay. Do you remember how to insert commas? So we have to insert commas after one period, after completion of one period. So see, first we are going to put insert the commas. First see this number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5-digit number. See the place values: ones, tens, hundred, thousand, and 10,000, right? So after thousand period we have to put comma. Then now see, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. So this is lakh period, comma. These are in thousand period, this. Okay, see this. Now see 54,000. Okay, after that this 489,277. Understand? So like this you have to put commas in the other numbers, in other examples. Okay, now see how can we arrange these four numbers in ascending order. First see how many digits are there in the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a 5-digit number. Okay, next see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6-digit number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is also 5-digit number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is also 6-digit number. So first, which come first, 5-digit or 6-digit? In ascending order, ascending order starts from small numbers to bigger numbers, right? So first compare this 5-digit, both 5-digit numbers are compared at first. See, first here 2 is present, here 5 is present. So we know that 2 is less than 5. So first in the ascending order, first come this 23,576. This come first. Okay, after that, so we have compared 5-digit number. So 23,576 come first. Next, which come first? This 5-digit number, 54,129. Now we have to compare these 6-digit numbers, right? See, in this number, leftmost end 7 is present, here 4 present. So 7 is obviously greater than 4, right? So what come here? 4. 489,277. And at last, what will come? 768,247. So this is the answer. Hope you all understand this. So C is done for you. You have to do A, B and D as your homework. Okay, now see question number 3. Insert commas and arrange the following numbers in descending order. So like the question number 2, we have to first insert the commas. After that, we have to arrange the following arrange these numbers in descending order. Descending orders means first bigger number should be put and after that smallest. Means descending order means bigger to smaller. Okay, see this, I have inserted the commas. Okay, now see how can we arrange these numbers in descending order. First see, these are all 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are all 6-digit numbers. Okay, now we have to compare the now digits from the leftmost end. Okay, see, 4 here, 4 4 4, same. 0 0 0 0, so this is also same. Then 9 4 9 2, here we get difference. In the first number, 9 is present in the 1000 place, right? In this, 4 is present in the 1000 place. Here, 9 also present. Here, 2 present. So, first, we are searching for bigger number first because this is descending order, right or not? So, first, we have to take these two because we got that these two numbers are bigger than these two numbers. Okay, see, next 9 is same, after that 4 comes, here 6 comes. So 4 is less than 6, right or not? Or we can say that 6 is greater than 4. So we got the biggest number among these numbers. What is the biggest number? This is the biggest number among these all 4. Now put that 4,09,600. 642. This is biggest. After that, what come next? This 4,09,462. Okay. After that, comparing these two numbers. Okay. So here, in the thousand period place, here 4 is present and here 2 is present. So 4 is greater than 2. We have to place this number here. Okay. See. 4,04,692. And the smallest number among this is 2,649. So this is the answer. Okay. See question number 4. Form the greatest and smallest numbers by using the given digits only once. So we have done this type of example in our previous class, right or not? So now here some digits are given. We have to use the digits and we have to form the greatest and smallest numbers. Okay, let's take an example. Example A. Okay, so we have to form greatest number by using these given digits. For to form the greatest number, we have to write the digits in descending order. See, descending order means from bigger to smaller. Among these, which digit is bigger? 9. So first we put 9 here. After 9, what come next? 7. Okay. After that, 6, then 5, then 2, then 0. Okay, so this is the greatest number. By we form this by using these all digits. Okay, now we have to form the smallest number. See, what is the smallest digits? 0, but we cannot put 0 first. So after that, what is the smallest among these? 2. Then we have to put 0. After that, 5, 6, 7, 9. So this is the smallest number. Understand? So I have done this. You have to do the others. Okay. So students, it's your today's class. Hope you all understand the sums, right?
Thank you. Have a great day ahead.